Many times as young believers, the question about Satan, devils, demons, and evil spirits frightens the growing Christian, and he is worried, he's bothered about the extent to which these spirits can do and how much influence they can have in his life. But the Bible makes us to understand that you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Hear this, child of God. In the book of Luke, the 10th chapter, the 19th verse, the Bible says, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Hear this, child of God. Nothing means nothing. Nothing will by any means hurt you. It doesn't matter the nature of the spirit. It doesn't matter the nature of the evil spirit, whether it's a demon, a devil, a Satan, whatever name it may go by, whether it's a python spirit or anything of such kinds. Hear this, child of God. When you become a beloved of God, child of God, you, my friend, have been energized and given authority over all powers of the enemy. So hear this. When we say in this channel that the enemy and the devils are not the problem, and that they cannot stop you, we know what we are talking about, because God is all-powerful. Hear this. If demons and devils were smart, perhaps the incident that transpired in the book of Luke, the 13th chapter from the 10th verse, the Bible says, "And he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath, and behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity for 18 years, and was bowed together, and could in no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him, and said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity." The wise thing to have done, perhaps, would have been to avoid Jesus. But I tell you, child of God, that devils, demons, and evil spirits, they cannot stop God's work. On this day, this woman had to be delivered, and she wasn't missing church on that day. She was at the right place at the right time, and she was with Jesus, and that devil and that evil spirit of infirmity could not stop her healing. Hear this, child of God. It doesn't matter what is affecting you or what has been tormenting you. Before Jesus, every knee bows and every tongue confess. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. It doesn't matter the words that have been proclaimed against you. No bewitchment will prosper against you, because God is in your case. Hear this, child of God. On several occasions, we see, as we see here, that this woman experienced the freedom and deliverance from this infirmity that had been on her for 18 years. Can you imagine that? Perhaps that spirit had gotten used to tormenting her, and it had concluded that she was going to remain a slave to it forever. But on this day, the master showed up, and I want to announce to somebody that your master is still up, and he still shows up, and you are about to be set free because of the truth you are coming to knowledge of. When we know the truth, the Bible says we can walk away from any chains that have held us bound previously. You know the truth, and that truth that you know will make you free. The first truth God is trying to bring to your notice today is that no devil can stop what he wants to do in your life. The same way it could not stop the deliverance of this woman, it will not and it cannot stop you. Another scenario we see is in the book of Acts, the 16th chapter, from the 16th verse. The Bible says, "And it came to pass, as we went to prayer, a certain damsel, possessed with a spirit of divination, met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. The same followed Paul and us, and cried, saying, These men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. And this did she many days. But Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out the same hour." Hear this, child of God. It is very crucial for us to take note here that the devil, perhaps if he were going to be smarter, would have done everything to avoid Paul, knowing what Paul carried, knowing that in another place a demon had said, "They know Paul." So knowing Paul, why could it not stop announcing itself and trying to hinder the works of the men of God in this place, because the devils are not as powerful as they have been painted. Hear this, child of God. In this place, we see that even the Spirit was affirming and confirming that God is the Most High. He says, these men are the servants of the Most High God. We show unto us the way of salvation. Even the devils know that the way of salvation can be shown by certain people of God. And child of God, you are that certain person. God has graced you. God has enabled you. God has called you to be that person who can show the way of salvation. And so on this occasion, when Paul gave the word and the instruction to that spirit, it heeded. It did just as the apostle had said. Hear this, child of God. There is no devil that can stop what God has ordained for you. No enemy can hinder the power and the grace of God that is upon your life. No devil can come against the name of Jesus Christ successfully and not bow down. Hear this, child of God. The God you serve is greater, he's bigger than any and everything that can try to come against you. When we are not conscious of what we have and who we are in God, the enemy's primary tool is to use deception and threat and ignorance to take advantage of the ignorance of the word and of the truth. This was the kind of experience that the disciples had when they were in training with Jesus in the book of Luke, the 10th chapter, from the 17th verse. After they had gone in line with the instruction that Jesus had given them, and they were surprised by their experience, because all their lives they had felt that they were powerless, but for the first time they had so many victories that they came back to Jesus rejoicing. And they said, and the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. Hear this, child of God. The name of Jesus is powerful. Everything bows to that name. And in this occasion, using that same name, they were able to have victories over those devils that all the while had tormented them, that all the while they thought were more powerful than them. In the 18th verse, and Jesus said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Child of God, this is the situation. The devil, Satan, is not as powerful as a lot of people think. He is not more powerful than your God. He is not more powerful than the Spirit of God inside of you. He is not what you may have been made to believe. Hear what the Bible says in the 20th verse. Is it notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Child of God, hear this. Because your names are written in heaven, your victory over the enemy in this life is for sure. They can't stop you. They won't stop you. You will get to that target. You will achieve that goal. You, my friend, we recover, you will get healed, you, my friend, will be celebrated in this life. Everything shall be restored unto you. May God, my friend, bless you, even as you walk in the consciousness of who you now are in God and where you are seated with Him. May God bless you.